Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, greetings to all of you in the mighty, precious and commendable name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Please bow down and join me for a prayer. Our Heavenly Father, Father, I thank you for this precious time that you have given in our lives to know about you and your love, Lord. Father, as we are entering into your word, please guide us and give us the knowledge required to understand thy word, Lord. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, I pray, Father. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, today we are going to magnify our focus on God, lifting him up as God the Father. God the Father. Please open your Bibles to Ephesians chapter 4 verse 6. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 6. As I read it, please go through it with all your heart and with all your soul. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 6. It says, "One God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all." As the scripture says, there is one God and he is the Father of all of us. There is one God and he is the Father of all of us. As a Christian, have you ever wondered about the person of God the Father? I have done this several times. Almost every Christian knows who the Lord Jesus Christ is. God the Holy Spirit, even though he is invisible, dwells in the inside of us. But when I think of God the Father, I am in awe and in fear, because the image that I have is that of a father who is somewhere up there in heaven ready to admonish and correct. Many of you might feel the same way as I do, but this is a wrong impression, because when we study the Bible, we will actually discover that he is the kind, loving and faithful God, because he is not an ordinary father. He is the special one, because he is the one and only father for all of us. He is a compassionate father who loves us more than we love him. Do you know that God actually does not deal with us according to our sins or as much as we deserve? If you don't agree, let me ask you a few questions. Can you see the sun every morning? Does it shine upon you? Can you see the moon every night? Can you experience the moonlight which makes us feel so pleasant? Is the rain showering upon you? And at last but not the least question, are you a righteous person or unrighteous? Give an answer for yourself to all these questions. If you think that you are righteous, if you heartfully think that you are a righteous person, then that is fine. But if you think that you are a sinner, if you think that you are unrighteous, then it is time for you to realize. Let me remind you that sin includes even a small lie. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, sin includes even a small lie. Sin includes disrespect towards the elders. Sin includes an evil thought in your mind. Sin includes murder, theft, disobedience, enmity, pride, anger, greed and what not. Give an answer for yourself to all these questions today. Let me show you a verse from the Bible that might melt your heart today. Please turn your pages to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 5 verse 45. The Gospel of Matthew chapter 5 verse 45. Gospel of Matthew chapter 5 verse 45. That you may be children of your Father in heaven, he causes his sun to rise on the evil and the good. He sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. As the scripture says, God causes the sun to rise on the evil and the good. He sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. That is what God's love is. By reading this verse wholeheartedly, can we say that this is what true love actually means? Do you still think that you are a sinner? Well, actually, we here see that God is not treating you that way. God is not treating us as sinners. Instead, he is still treating us as his children. Are you in a thought that God does not love you? Oh, please, my dear brothers and sisters, do not think that way. Because every morning when you rise, God says, I love you, my child, by rising the sun for you. And every night, God again reminds you with the moonlight that He still loves you. To be true, if we think more precisely, God is the one who first wishes us good morning every morning. He is the one who first wishes us good night every night. You know what? It is not God who doesn't love us. It is we who do not love God. Think of what you have given to God till now. I'm not talking of the pleasures of the earth. It might be a little thing for you, but for God, even if you give a little thing wholeheartedly, it makes Him feel glad. I'm not even talking of the big things. Did you even give a little thanks to God with all your heart? Of course, many say it with their mouth, but only few say it with their heart. In what category do you place yourself today? In many or in few? I hope you all are aware of the poor widow in the Bible who offered 2 coins. She offered all that she had with her whole heart. My dear brothers and sisters, the same is similar when it comes to you and me. Even if we give God a little thanks with our whole heart, it gives Him great joy. Let me show you another verse from the Bible today. Please turn your pages to the book of Jeremiah. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 23, verses 23 and 24. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 23, verses 23 and 24. The scripture says, Am I only a God nearby, declares the Lord, and not a God far away? Who can hide in secret places so that I cannot see them, declares the Lord? Do not I fill heaven and earth, declares the Lord? From this scripture we can understand that God fills heaven and earth. God fills heaven and earth. According to science, the circumference of earth is about 40,075 kilometers. 40,075 kilometers, which is about 131 million feet. 131 million feet, just think about it. I have shared only about the size of the earth. You think of heaven. We cannot even imagine how big God is. Imagine, oh no, it's actually the reality. You, me and all of us in front of God would not even be the size of a mustard seed. Our God, even though we are not even the size of a mustard seed in front of Him, notices all of us. He knows everything about us. He knows each and every little thing about us. You might be surprised to know that God knows when you sit and when you stand. God knows when you lie down and when you wake up. You might be surprised to see that God also knows a word before it comes into your mouth. You want to see it? Please come to me to Psalm 139. Psalm 139. Please turn your pages to Psalm 139. You please read the whole Psalm later, but for the time's sake, we'll go through a few verses from the starting. Psalm 139 from the starting. You have searched me, Lord, and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you, Lord, know it completely. Shall we read it again? Shall we read it again? Before a word is on my tongue, you, Lord, know it completely. What a wonderful scripture. We can here see that God knows everything, each and every little thing about us. Even though we are nothing in front of Him, He knows everything about us. Isn't it wonderful to know that there is someone who is always watching over us, watching us when we sit, watching us when we lie down? At some point of time, we all might have thought that we need someone to be with us forever. Did you ever get a thought like that? For us, forever means till the death, but for God, forever has no end. God is ready to be with us forever and ever, even after our death. Isn't it wonderful to know that there is really someone who is always with us? But the saddest part of our life is that we fail to notice that special one. Our God is so great and so mighty, But still, He is noticing all of us. And though we are nothing in front of Him, we don't even recognize His love and His presence in our life. My dear brothers and sisters, also know that God notices our good deeds as well as our bad deeds. It is not a big matter for God to destroy us. It won't even take a single second for Him to destroy us. Always remember that through His word everything was made, and the same way it can be destroyed. In spite of knowing our evil deeds, God is still watching over us with love. Do remember that only by God's grace we are still alive. We often in our prayers ask God to fulfill our desires. It's good, because God is our Father and it is good to seek His help. The only matter is that, are we in a position to ask God to fulfill our desires, or are we in a position to regret for all that we have lost and for all the love of God that we didn't recognize till now? Nature is the best instance that shows us God's love. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, each and everything around us only shows us God's love. If you look into it with your whole heart, if you look into it with a passion of love towards God, you can find His love in everything. You can find the special one in everything. You can find our Father in everything. You can find our Father's love in everything. My dear brothers and sisters, do you know that the first ever relationship that was started was of the father and a child? As a father wishes to have his children around him, so is our Heavenly Father. Our Heavenly Father wished to have us around him. We have asked our Father for many things. From now on, it's time for us to give. Shall we give him all that he needs? All that he needs is only you. Yes, dear children of God, he wants only you. Instead of asking, it's time for us to give. Think of it. Just think of it once. How old are you? Are you 15? Are you in your 20s or 30s or 40s or 50s or 60s? Just go through your past. Recollect all that God has given you. Also recollect all that you have given to Him. Many of us have given nothing to God till this very moment. Don't worry, but feel happy that God has given us this very moment to be His child. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, we can still breathe. That means God has given us this very moment to be His child. Keeping in mind all that our Father has given us, shall we give Him what He needs? On earth, we often try to make our parents feel proud of us. We feel very glad when our father or mother says, "I'm proud of you, my son. I'm proud of you, my daughter." We feel so happy when our father or mother declares in public about us. Then what about our Heavenly Father who is waiting for all of us over centuries? Are we getting ready to make our Heavenly Father feel proud of us? God our Father suffered as much as the Lord Jesus Christ did on the cross, because He had to watch as His only begotten Son went through all the agony, pain and suffering. Yes, He suffered as much as the Lord Jesus Christ did on the cross. When man fell in the Garden of Eden, God had to drive him out because of his disobedience. Since then, God wanted to reconcile man to Himself. That is why He has sent His only begotten Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, to this earth to save all of us. And we can clearly know that in a familiar verse, the Gospel of John chapter 3 verse 16. No need of opening it because we are very familiar to it. It says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life." What a great sacrifice that God our Father has given. In the Gospel of John chapter 3 verse 16, as we know it very well, we can see two great sacrifices. One is of the Father and the other is of the Lord Jesus Christ. Sometimes we just don't appreciate the magnitude of the sacrifice. If you are a father of a child, imagine yourself in the situation. Call for your child and ask him to stand in front of you and go through my words. As you look at him, imagine that many are seeking for the death of your only child. He is being beaten severely. He is nailed to the cross. He went through a lot of pain and suffering. In spite of knowing that all this would happen, imagine that you yourself got ready to send your only child to such a harsh situation. How would you feel? Can you sense the pain? If you can sense the pain, Think of how God the Father would have suffered. Think of his feeling. Think of his situation once.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, all that our Father wishes from all of us is to turn to him with love, to believe in the Lord Jesus and his sacrifice, and repent.
Yes, the sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ is important for all of us. Because a verse in Hebrews chapter 9 verse 22 says, a verse from Hebrews chapter 9 verse 22 says, And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without the shedding of blood there is no remission. Without the sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ, there is no remission. Without the sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ, there is no salvation. Before concluding, all I can say that These words are not enough to describe God and his love. These words are not enough to describe his unconditional love. Nothing in this world can be given as a written gift for his love except for our life. Let me tell you another verse from the Bible before concluding. Proverbs chapter 23. Proverbs chapter 23 verse 24 says, "The father of a righteous child brings him great joy." Our Father in heaven finds great joy only with our righteous life. Living a holy life is the only gift that we can give our Father. Shall we live a holy life and make our Father the happiest Father? Shall we make our judgment day a proud one? Shall we be the one who would be called by the Father? My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, enough of asking. Let's all live a holy life and give this little life as a gift to God. My dear brothers and sisters, at last let me remind you that there is someone who is, who was, and who will be with us forever and ever. And he is none other than our Father in heaven. Our Father in heaven is the one who is, who was, and who will be with us forever and ever. Forever and ever, which means even after our death. Shall we seek his love, which is ready to accept us even now? Think of it, my dear brothers and sisters. And please join me once again in a little prayer.
Oh my loving Heavenly Father, Father, I once again thank you for the precious time that you have given us to know about you and your love, Lord. Father, as we have known about your love today, help us to reflect the same in our lives, Lord. Father, I request you to change our hearts today. Father, also help us not to fall for Satan, but to always stand for you, Lord. If it is thy will, please shower your blessings on all of us, Lord. In the mighty and glorious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.